Hey kids, welcome back. So excited to be with you. We're continuing our series, Press Play, where we're continuing down the road of confidence. And what we're saying confidence is seeing ourselves the way God sees us. Now, we're gonna dive into that deeper, but it's time to get down and bust out all your dance moves because it's worship time. So go ahead and stand up and let's get ready.
Searching, your love was never far. You made a way to get to me. You were the whisper leading me to your heart. Forever I belong to you. Now I can see clearly, my God, you are for me. You won't let go. Your love won't let me down. And I know it's true. Yeah, I know that.
Overwhelmed by the weight of Hey everybody, welcome back. Now it's time for one of my favorite parts of the service, which is the memory verse. So if you want to follow along, it's right up here. And this is such an amazing memory verse because it actually has our word confident in there, which is what our series Press Play is all about. So I'm gonna say it once if you don't know it yet, and then we'll do it all together. So our memory verse is, being confident of this, that he who began a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus. Philippians 1, verse 6. Awesome. So now you all heard it. So now I think you all know it. And let's do it all together on three. One, two, three. Being confident of this, that he who began a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus. Philippians 1, verse 6. Awesome. Hey, you all sounded great, and I can't wait to see you again for another memory verse. See ya.
The Bible, it's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how he created us and loves us so much that he made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. Now, for an amazing story, inspired by the book of Ephesians, chapter 6, verses 10 through 17.
The Apostle Paul spent his last 2 years as a prisoner in Rome. But even though he wasn't free to travel, he shared God's truth with everyone who visited and often wrote strong letters to the churches he had started. One of those letters went to the believers at the church in Ephesus.
Finally, let the Lord make you strong. Depend on his mighty power. Put on all of God's armor. Then you can remain strong against the devil's evil plans.
Now, armor isn't something we see every day. Maybe you think of this. Or this. But remember, Paul wrote this letter when he was in prison. In the book of Acts, his friend Luke explains,
when we got to Rome, Paul was allowed to live by himself, but a soldier guarded him.
This means that Paul was guarded by at least one Roman soldier every single hour of the day. In fact, Paul was probably even chained to that soldier.
So every day, Paul had a great opportunity to study this armor in real detail. He knew that when dressed up in armor, a Roman soldier could withstand any attack by an enemy. Paul also knew that the main enemy we face isn't one we can see.
Our fight is not against human beings. It is against the rulers, the authorities, and the powers of this dark world. It is against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly world. So put on all of God's armor. Evil days will come. But you will be able to stand up to anything. And after you have done everything you can, you will still be standing.
See, our fight is not with human beings. Paul reminds us that the real enemy is spiritual forces of evil. Now, that might sound really weird and creepy, but it's actually very simple. God has an enemy called Satan. Now, we know at the end Satan is defeated, but right now Satan is trying to mess with what God loves most. People. We're fighting a battle with an enemy we can't see. And because of this, Paul says, we need a very special kind of armor.
So remain strong in the faith. Put the belt of truth around your waist.
A belt tied up loose clothing and held weapons, so a soldier was all ready to go.
God wants us to prepare ourselves with the truth that he loves us and is always with us, and that he'll give us the wisdom to face any tough decision we have to make.
Put the armor of godliness on your chest.
This piece, sometimes called a breastplate, protected a soldier's heart and lungs and stomach. You know, all the important stuff.
Paul says our protection is godliness. That means simply following God in what we do and say by loving God and loving others. It's our best defense against the enemy.
Wear on your feet what will prepare you to tell the good news of peace.
Check these out. Kind of sandals, kind of cleats. Roman soldiers actually wore shoes with nails sticking out of the bottom so they could get a good grip on rough and rocky roads.
Paul says the way we can get a grip is to share the message of God's peace with everybody we meet, wherever our feet will take us. Thanks to Jesus, everyone can have peace with God.
Also, pick up the shield of faith. With it, you can put out all the flaming arrows of the evil one.
Rejected! A Roman soldier's shield was everything. Not only could a soldier block arrows and swords and spears, but he could get right behind this and charge, pushing back the enemy.
And that's exactly what strong faith in God and His promises can do for us. Maybe the enemy tries to sneak in with the thought that God doesn't love me. But you can block that right away because you know that nothing can separate you from God's love. He promises that. Or maybe you're struck with a wave of doubt that you can't make a hard choice. But you can block that when you remember that God promises to guide your steps when you trust Him.
Put on the helmet of salvation.
A helmet protects just what you think, your head and mind.
The enemy likes to sneak attack with small lies and spiraling thoughts of negativity. But if you put on the helmet of salvation, trusting in God and following Jesus, that'll protect your mind.
And take the sword of the Holy Spirit. The sword is God's word.
When the enemy attacks, Paul says we have a way to fight back. Our weapon is the sword of God's word. Jesus himself used God's words from Scripture when he was tempted by Satan. As Paul says,
put on all of God's armor. Evil days will come, but you will be able to stand up to anything. And after you have done everything you can, you will still be standing.
When you discover God's words written down in the Bible and hold them in your head and your heart, you can stand up to any attack by the enemy.
So, in the same way that you wouldn't get behind home plate to catch a fastball without the proper equipment, or you wouldn't go to catch flying hockey pucks in the goal without the proper pads, Paul reminds us to always be equipped for the battles that we're gonna face in life. And you know, sometimes in life, everything doesn't turn out perfect. Sometimes things happen that we don't expect to, and things don't go the way that it seems like they should. And that's because there's an enemy that we can't see. You know, I'm sure some of you have experienced what it's like to feel real doubt or real loneliness, or to have negative thoughts about yourself or about others. And maybe even sometimes it feels like you can't know what's true or what's just a lie. But with God's armor, truth, godliness, peace, faith, salvation, and God's word, we can actually be equipped and be protected in those times when we feel vulnerable and we feel like there's all these lies all around us. So we're gonna pray now. Father God, I thank you that you equip us with your armor, Lord. I thank you for the ways that you help us and you guide us and you protect us in those times when we feel like we have nothing, Lord. We know that we can lean on you, and we know that when we lean into what you have equipped us with, that we can actually get through these tough circumstances in life. So Lord, for everybody that is listening, I pray that you would be with them. I pray that you would be equipping them with your armor, that whatever trials they're going through, you would be right alongside them, and that you would let them know just how deeply you love them and how they can do it, how they can get through whatever they're going through, Jesus. I thank you so much for your everlasting, for your steadfast love. It is in your name we pray, amen. Amen. Hey, I hope that you had an awesome time learning about the armor of God, and I hope that as you go through your week and even your whole month, that you'll be able to see how God is equipping you to deal with whatever you need to deal with. See ya.